Gary, or a nil-each draw with Portadown today. Give us your thoughts on the game.
Yeah, for all our dominance of the ball today and all the possession we had, we just didn't create enough clear-cut chances. I think we dominated the game from pretty much start to finish. Maybe a 10-minute period in the first half where we weren't just quite as dominant, but certainly the second half it was all us and there's only one team trying to win the game. Our decision making in the final third needs to be better today. Like we put too many balls in from too many deep positions. We didn't really work it into better positions in order to deliver a better standard of cross. You know, we snatched at a few things as well, but. I can't help, the referee hasn't done us any favours today. I think there was a couple of penalty decisions that could have gone our way. On another day it might have done, like you mean, but again, we just haven't quite done enough in order to force the ball over the line. So lots of positives in terms of we keep possession of the ball really well, so we have done, we popped that around quite well at times. We kept a clean sheet, which is obviously a big positive, so it is, because we've got to be hard to beat, and that's what I look for every week, you know, is a clean sheet. So a few positives, like you mean, but more disappointment in that we didn't take our chances in the final third or create enough chances in the final third.
We scored one goal. It was ruled out for offside. Did you get a good enough view on that?
No, from our angle, I was too busy cheering, so I thought it was in the back of the net, because I knew if we broke that, you know, if we got the one, I didn't see any way back for Portadown into the game. You know, they set out to, I think, you know, you see them celebrating there at the end. The point was what they came for. I mean, the point is what they left with, you know, which is disappointing from our end that we haven't done enough to win the game. But yeah, I'll have to see that again. Curtis said it was borderline. It must have been quite close. Like, it's a good finish it was from him. Good delivery into the box by Eric. You know, it's that's what happens when you get a quality delivery. Like, you know, and it's just, again, we just haven't done that enough today.
And you mentioned there are penalty decisions you could have and could have had. Did you get a good enough view in them?
Well, I think the one that Stevie's backing into, like, he's holding the ball back, but the lad puts his arms around him and they both fall over. Like, I've seen them given time and time again. The one he gets tripped, again, he's dangled a leg out and Stevie's caught it, like, so he has, you know, and you dangle a leg out, you ask referee to make a decision. There's the Henderson handball incident, like, you mean, where the boys were convinced that Henderson on the arm. So he did when he tries to clear the ball, like, so again. Yeah, I don't want to get to the point where we depend on other people. Like, you mean, we don't want to depend on other positions to get us results. We don't want to depend on the referee or anything to get results. I want to get us results, not there by our own merit. So it is. But again, if they're blatant and they're there, like, you mean, then the referee's got a tough decision to make, and I'll have to look at him again out there to see if he got them right or wrong.
Nacho Nova came on the day and had to get subbed off. Is he wasn't fit enough?
No, it was just a wee hamstring. It's just very, very frustrating. Hamstrings are a bit like that. Like, you know, he felt strong. He was over at Rangers, so he was doing quite a bit of rehab. So he did, you know, he'd been doing sprint work yesterday, so he was declared fit and ready to go. And it's just a bit unfortunate that it's one of them ones. Like, he felt ready, he felt good. He's had to sit on the bench on a cold day today, and because he's like I say, he's been out for about 10 days now, so he did his warm up. He felt ready to go, so we were chasing the game, so we put three up front. I wanted an extra striker in there because I wanted to win the game. I wasn't happy with a point coming out of that game the way we were so dominant. So it's just very, very unfortunate. Our wee hamstrings are a bit like that, you know. He's just a wee tighten up or a tweak in that, like, domain, and it just, unfortunately, it just wasn't. It just kind of, yeah, it's unfortunate for Nacho because he's worked hard in that day to try and put himself back in contention, and unfortunately it's something now we're going to have to look at to see how bad it is.
And going ahead now into next week, were you open to have any fresh faces back for your injury during the week?
Well, the reserves play Tuesday night, so Stevie McAloran will get another run out. He was very impressive for the reserves last week, so he was, and last Wednesday night. Kim Neeson done very well for the reserves too, as did Alex Lou. So I'll go down again, lad. We'll watch them this week, and we'll see if we can get Mackers more involved. Not there, and obviously Kim came on the day, so we did. So it's just about having everybody fit and available and being competitive as much as possible.